I must go down to the seas again, to the lonely sea in the sky, and all I ask is a tall ship and a star to steer her by. And the wheels kick, and the wind's song, and the white sails shaking, and the grey mist on the sea's face, and a grey dawn breaking. I must go down to the seas again, for the call of the running tide is a wild call, and a clear call that may not be denied. And all I ask is a windy day, with the white clouds flying, and the flung spray, and the blown spume, and the sea gulls crying. I must go down to the seas again, to the vagrant gypsy life, to the gull's way and the whale's way, where the wind's like a whetted knife, and all I ask is a merry yarn from a laughing fellow rover, and quiet sleep and a sweet dream when the long trick's over. Quinquiream of Nineveh, from distant Ophir, rowing home to haven in sunny Palestine, with a cargo of ivory and apes and peacocks, sandalwood, cedarwood, and sweet white wine. Stately Spanish galleon, coming from the isthmus, dipping through the tropics by the palm-green shores, with a cargo of diamonds, emeralds, amethysts, topazes and cinnamon, and gold moidores. Dirty British coaster with a salt-cake smokestack, butting through the channel in the mad March days, with a cargo of tine coal, road rail, pig lead, firewood, ironware, and cheap tin. In the harbor, in the island, in the Spanish seas, are the tiny white houses and the orange trees. And day long, night long, the cool and pleasant breeze of the steady trade winds blowing. There's the red wine, the nutty Spanish ale, the shuffle of the dancers, the old salt's tale, the squeaking fiddle and the suffing in the sail of the steady trade winds blowing. And at nights, there's fireflies and the yellow moon, and in the ghostly palm trees the sleepy tune of the quiet voice calling me, the long, low croon of the steady trade winds blowing. I must go down to the seas again, to the lonely sea in the sky, and all I ask is a tall ship and a star to steer her by. And the wheels kick, and the wind's song, and the white sails shaking, and the grey mist on the sea's face, and a grey dawn breaking. I must go down to the seas again, for the call of the running tide is a wild call and a clear call that may not be denied. And all I ask is a windy day with the white clouds flying and the flung spray and the blown spume and the sea gulls crying. I must go down to the seas again, to the vagrant gypsy life, to the gull's way and the whale's way, where the wind's like a whetted knife, and all I ask is a merry yarn from a laughing fellow rover, and quiet sleep and a sweet dream when the long trick's over. Quinquirim of Nineveh, from distant Ophir, rowing home to haven in sunny Palestine, with a cargo of ivory and apes and peacocks, sandalwood, cedarwood, and sweet white wine. Stately Spanish galleon, coming from the isthmus, dipping through the tropics by the palm-green shores, with a cargo of diamonds, emeralds, amethysts, topazes and cinnamon, and gold moidores. Dirty British coaster with a salt-cake smokestack, butting through the channel in the mad March days, with a cargo of tine coal, road rail, pig lead, firewood, ironware, and cheap tin trays. I hold that when a person dies, his soul returns again to earth. Arrayed in some new flesh disguise, another mother gives him birth. With sturdier limbs and brighter brain, the old soul takes the road again. Such is my own belief and trust. This hand that holds the pen, has many a hundred times been dust, and turned as dust to dust again. These eyes of mine have blinked and shone in Thebes, in Troy, in Babylon. All that I rightly think or do, or make or spoil, or bless or blast, is curse or blessing justly due for sloth or effort in the past. My life's a statement of the sum of vice indulged or overcome. I know that in my lives to be, my sorry heart will ache and burn and worship unavailingly the woman whom I used to spurn, and shake to see another have the love I spurned, the love she gave. And I shall know in angry words, in gibes and mocks and many a tear, a carrion flock of homing birds, the gibes and scorns I uttered here, the brave word that I failed to speak will brand me dastard on the cheek. And as I wander on the roads, I shall be helped and healed and blessed. Dear words shall cheer and be as goads to urge to heights before unguessed. My road shall be the road I made. All that I gave shall be repaid. So shall I fight, so shall I tread, in this long war beneath the stars. So shall a glory wreathe my head, so shall I faint and show the scars, until this case, this clogging mold, be smithied all to kingly gold. not of the princes and prelates with periwig charioteers, riding triumphantly laureled to lap the fat of the years. Rather, the scorned, the rejected, the men hemmed in with the spears. The men of the tattered battalion which fights till it dies, dazed with the dust of the battle, the din and the cries. The men with the broken heads and the blood running into their eyes. Not the bemedaled commander, beloved of the throne, riding cock-horse to parade when the bugles are blown, but the lads who carried the copier and cannot be known. Not the ruler for me, but the ranker, the tramp of the road, the slave with the sack on his shoulders, pricked on with the goad, the man with too weighty a burden, too weary a load. The sailor, the stoker of steamers, the man with the clout, the chantyman bent at the halyards, putting a tune to the shout, the drowsy man at the wheel, and the tired lookout. Others may sing of the wine and the wealth and the mirth, the portly presence of potentates goodly in girth. Mine be the dirt and the dross, the dust and the scum of the earth. Theirs be the music, the color, the glory, the gold. Mine be a handful of ashes, a mouthful of mold. Of the maimed, of the halt, and the blind, and the rain, and the cold. Of these shall my songs be fashioned, my tales be told. My friend, my bonny friend, when we are old, and hand in hand go tottering down the hill, may we be rich in love's refined gold, may love's gold coin be current with us still. May love be sweeter for the vanished days, and your most perfect beauty still as dear as when your troubled singer stood at gaze in that dear march of a most sacred year. May what we are be all we might have been, and that potential perfect, O my friend, and may there still be many sheaves to glean in our love's acre, comrade, till the end. And may we find, when ended is the page, death but a tavern on our pilgrimage.